Hi everyone, it's Kiera here. Welcome back to my channel. And today I want to show you how to make some hummus. Now, you're going to need some pita bread. And I have some white pita bread here. And some brown whole wheat pita bread. I'm actually not going to actually physically show you how I did my hummus. I'm just going to show you kind of how to sort of do it, just because I'm not very good. I don't have any editing or anything like that. I'm really sorry, but so it would have been probably a long video to kind of do it without the editing. So anyways, to get back to it, you need some pita bread. You can do white or brown or both. You need some parsley, some garlic. I usually use fresh garlic, but I don't have any garlic right now. Fresh garlic right now. I need to go grocery shopping, so I just used this garlic that was in this jar. You'll need some lemon juice. Of course, some chickpeas. Usually I use one can of chickpeas, and this is a no-name brand, but I don't, this is the first time using this, and I'm sure like they're are going to be alright. They're chickpeas or chickpeas, but I usually get like the Unico kind or any kind that's kind of on sale actually. So, but this is what I had in my pantry, so I use that. And you're going to need some olive oil. I know this is extra virgin olive oil, but you can use any kind of olive oil. This next ingredient is very important. It's called tahini. See if you can see that there. And tahini is, how do I describe it? It's sesame. Where did it say on here? I can't see it, but it's like a sesame oil. So you'll need tahini, and it's called tahini. And this is what it looks like inside. And you'll only use a teaspoon of this. You don't really need very much. So tahini. And then I put some crackers out here as well. You can use tortilla chips, pita bread, crackers, vegetables, and yeah. So you'll need one can of chickpeas, a couple drops of lemon juice depending on how much you like it. I use actually a lot of garlic, but if you don't really like a lot of garlic, probably just maybe two cloves. I usually four or six because I love garlic. Okay, so if you don't really like garlic, two cloves probably be enough. And then a little parsley, I don't know, just whatever, however you like it. And then, like I said, one little spoon of this. You really don't need a whole lot. And then the olive oil. See, when I do my cooking, I don't really follow any recipes or anything like that. I'm the type of cook who likes to just kind of like a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So I'm not really sure what to tell you. Just, you don't want to cover all, like once you get the chickpea, or that's the other thing, you're going to need a food processor or some sort of blender or something to blend this all together. So when you get your chickpeas into your blender, you don't want to totally cover the chickpeas, because if you totally cover them, then you might need another little bit of can of chickpeas. So just like half, maybe try half covering the chickpeas, and then if that isn't enough, because what you're trying to do is kind of like make a sort of like a paste. I'll show you in a minute. Just maybe try half covering the chickpeas with the olive oil, and then you can always add a little bit more if you need it. But once you add the olive oil and you put too much in, you can't exactly take it out. So use your eye on that. Sorry, I really wish I could have actually done a tutorial on this, but anyways, this is what I have to do, so sorry about that. Anyways, now I'm just going to show you what it turns out like. And you get a platter, and you put it out like this. See, I've got the pita bread, there's the whole wheat, there's the I don't know if you're going to see that, the white. And then this is the, and I put some orange peppers on there. You can put, like, carrot sticks would be nice with hummus. Any, like, type of veggie you can dip in this. And so that's it there. That's the finished product. So I'm just going to set this down here. And I'm going to spread it onto one to show you more of what it looks like. So there's the consistency of it. And I'm just going to put it on like that. So then you can just, you just want, you don't really want it, like, you kind of want it like a paste, but you want to be able to spread it. So you don't want it too much of a paste. So that's what it looks like there. And oh my gosh, this is so good. This is very good. But I do have to say, I would prefer fresh garlic in this instead of the jarred garlic. But it's still very good. So if you only have the ones that are in the jar, then that's fine. You'll still like it, but it's very good. And this is very good to take to, like, potlucks and functions and things like that. Like, when I take it to my family functions, it's gone in seconds. And, like I said, you don't have to use the, if you're, like, say, in your diet, you've cut out bread or whatever, you can always use vegetables and... or crackers, I know that's sort of a bread thing, or the tortilla chips. So you can always switch it up. And hummus is very good for you, and especially if you're making it, it's more even better for you if you're making it from scratch like I just did. And I wish I could have shown you that process, but like I said, I don't have any editing. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this inspires you to... you know, to do some summer appetizers, and I think I'm going to do a few more of this type of video, but this is one summer appetizer that you could take to a potluck party in the summer, and people will just go nuts over it. Yeah, so thanks again, and I hope you enjoy, and I wish you were all here so we could all have some, but maybe another time. Thanks again, guys. We'll talk to you in the next video. Bye-bye.